Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So your wait is over now. RBI Grade B 2021 notification has come out and the forms will be available from January 28 onwards. So this is something that you already know. But you, what is new that I'm going to tell you? The new thing is that this morning tale series is definitely going to help you crack your phase 1 exam of RBI Grade B. So from now onwards, you have to pay attention to the morning tales, to the Spotlight magazine. And guys, many students have asked me this question, whether the morning tales or the Spotlight PDF should be used for making the notes. So let me clarify here that guys, the questions, the information that I am telling you are all provided in the Spotlight magazine. This video is for clarifying or for making you understand the news provided in the Spotlight magazine more clear. So in order to clear those news, in order to enhance your understanding, this video is provided to you guys. So you can use either source, be it the morning tales or be it the Spotlight magazine. You can make your own notes. But remember, the notes that you are going to make should be concise so that you can easily memorize the facts and you can have a quick glance at the end of your tenure, at the end of your preparation tenure. Now, apart from this, there is one information as well that I want to share with you. So the information is that your examination for phase 1 is in the first week of March itself. So the current affairs that you have to prepare for your phase 1 should be of 6 months. So November onwards, you have to prepare the current affairs. November to current affairs. Now, for the month of November and December, I have taken the 100 MCQs for SEBI Grade A class. You can use those videos and revise the questions from there only for November and December. For January, February, I will be providing you with the complete comprehensive Spotlight revision sessions. And for that, you have to wait for a while and keep watching the Morning Tales video and reading the Spotlight magazine on a regular basis. So that's all, that was the information that I wanted to share with you in the beginning of this video. So let's begin this video in which various new and interesting questions are there, which are definitely helpful for your phase 1 also. So let's begin the video. But before that, guys, if you are new here, then do subscribe and hit this bell notification so that in the upcoming days, whenever we will be providing you with the live sessions of various topics and various different important aspects of RBI Grade B examination, you will get the notification instantly and you will not waste or you will not miss any session. So quickly subscribe and hit this bell notification. And if your friends are also giving the examination, then do share this channel link with them as well. And this is the Telegram group, guys. Here your queries related to your examination are resolved. So this is something that I have told you many times. So this is for the new students who are watching me for the first time. Subscribe this channel from the link given in the description below, because this channel will help you resolving your queries. So this is the new code from my side. Since the examination date has been announced, notification is about to come. Therefore, you have to push yourself because no one else is going to do that for you. So keep this note in your mind, keep this code intact in your mind and start preparing for the examination. Don't wait for anything any longer. Just start your preparation and remember, if you have any doubts related to your preparation, then I am here to resolve them. So don't feel hesitant in asking your queries. You can ask them in the comment section as well as on the Telegram group. Chaliye. So let's begin this video with the first question. Let's begin the session. What is the name of the app launched by Uttar Pradesh to help youth to explore self-employment opportunities? You have Udyam Sarathi, Udyam Sathi, Udyam Parakrami, Udyam Manthar, Udyam Bazaar. So since the purpose of this application is mentioned in the question itself, it is to help the youth explore the employment opportunities in the state, this application has been launched. Now, what is the name of that application? It is Udyam Sarathi. So, under this application, or we can say through this application, the Uttar Pradesh government will provide guidance to the youth in different kinds of fields of business opportunities through which they can generate employment for themselves, through which they can open their own ventures. Apart from this, the thing that you should remember is that this has been launched under the one district, one product scheme of the Uttar Pradesh government. So this app has been prepared under this scheme. What is the purpose of this scheme? One district, one product. Basic purpose of this scheme, or we can say the broad line of this scheme, is that it is to promote MSMEs in the state. How the state aims to promote MSMEs through this scheme? Basic idea is that one district, one product. A district will be specialized in one type of product, and since the specialization of that product will be in that district, obviously the export of that product will be increased. So basically, in order to make a district special or specialized in one type of product, the exports will be increased through this program. So this is the main idea behind this one district, one product scheme. One district will be specialized in one type of product, and through this scheme, the MSMEs will be promoted. So their welfare will be ensured through this scheme. So that's all for this application. Apart from this, while launching the application, the CM of this state, Yogi Adityanath, has announced that Abhyutha Abhyudaya. So this is the name of the coaching centers that the state government will be establishing in the state. Now, what is the purpose of this coaching center? The purpose is to provide coaching to the youth of the state for cracking competitive exams. So you have to remember the name of the coaching centers and the purpose. The purpose is competitive exams. Apart from this, Abhyudaya, one more announcement was made by the CM, and that announcement was UP Gaurav Samman. So the UP Gaurav Samman is given to people who bring laurels to the state, who do something great to make the state proud, and this award will be given to people. Basically, the institution of this award has been announced, that the state government has instituted this award, and the awardees will be provided the award at a later stage. But remember, the people who bring laurels to the state will be provided with this award. So these were some of the announcements made by CM Yogi Adityanath. And here the question ends. And we are moving on to our next question. So this is again a first. So let's discuss what first is it. Which institute has unveiled aqua rejuvenation plant, first ever wastewater treatment technology model? So let's read out the option first. We have Central Building Research Institute, Advanced Materials and Processes Research Institute, Central Drug Research Institute, Central Mechanical Engineering Research Institute, and Center for Cellular Molecular Biology. These are the five options. Remember guys, all these five institutes are affiliated with CSIR, Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. So all these are CSIR affiliated institutes. Now which one is the right answer? The right answer is option D, Central Mechanical Research Institute, which is in Durgapur. Where is this Durgapur located? It is in West Bengal. So you have to remember some of these basic news, basic facts from the main news. Now what is the purpose of this aqua rejuvenation plant? This purpose is the wastewater treatment plant, and this is specifically for the farming needs, or basically the water which will be treated through this plant will be used in irrigation. And that's all. That is the whole purpose of this aqua rejuvenation plant, which is the first ever wastewater treatment technology model for farming, or we can say for irrigation. So that's all for this question. Our next question is, which state has launched India's first of its kind children's library on a boat? So this is basically a floating library that has been launched in India. Now, which state has launched it? So you have Maharashtra, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka and Kerala in the options. Out of these, West Bengal is the right answer. So there is one significant question related to this boat library. And what is that question? The question is, on which river will it cruise? So the answer is Hooghly. Guys, do remember this fact as well, because the other way around that this question can be asked is that India's first library, first boat library cruises on which river? So the answer would be Hooghly River. Remember Hooghly River and West Bengal. When is the National Tourism Day observed? So recently this National Tourism Day was observed. Let me tell you the date of this day. So the date is January 25. And the theme of this day is Dekho Apna Desh. So this is a very simple theme. Dekho Apna Desh, National Tourism Day. And the date is January 25. So we have discussed it at the national level. Let's talk about it at the world level. So guys, do you know when is the World Tourism Day observed? If you know, then mention it in the comment section below. When is the World Tourism Day observed and what was its theme in 2020? So tell me in the comment section. And now let's discuss the next question. Who has been awarded the Subhash Chandra Bose Apada Prabandhan Puraskar in the individual category? So you have Vipul Bansal, Anil Yadav, Gurdeep Singh, Rajendra Kumar Bhandari and Vivek Singh. The right answer is option D, Rajendra Kumar Bhandari in the individual category. Now Apada is disaster, Prabhandan is management and Puraskar is award. So this award is in the field of disaster management, and this person has been awarded this award because of his contribution in disaster management and geohazard manage. Now we have talked about individual category. What is the other category? The other category is institutional category. So in this category, Environment and Ecological Development Society was awarded in the institutional category. So this is short formed as SEEDS. So this, the acronym of this organization is SEEDS. Remember that this organization won in the institutional category and Rajendra Kumar Bhandari won in the individual category. Now guys, there is a unique point, or we can say there is a fact related to this award, and that fact is that this award is given annually on the birth anniversary of Subhash Chandra Bose. So Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose 125th birth anniversary is definitely going to be observed in 2022, and for that a central committee has been formed. So guys, here a clarification is there for you. In December, the central government announced that this committee would be headed by Amit Shah, but lately Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced to chair that committee himself. So this is the new revelation that you have to keep in mind. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is chairing the committee that is for observing the 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So these are the facts that you have to remember. Now my question from you is that when is the birth anniversary, when is the birthday of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose observed? So you have to tell me the Rise of Rajasic Nation book. You have five options and the right answer is option C, Gautam Chikmani. So that's all guys for this session. I hope that you have enjoyed and learned a lot during the session. And in the end, I just want to say, don't panic about the examination. If you have, you still have 1 month to prepare for the exam. And we as the mentors are with you all the time. So you can ask your queries from us and don't worry, prepare hard for the examination. Thank you so much for watching the video.